This is the camera bag that I use on a day-to-day basis. Want to know what's inside it and why? Stick around. Hi, Paul here from Photogenius. Now, it's been 2 years since I did a video about what's inside my camera bag. And in that time, some things have changed. So I thought it was time for an update. Now, what's in my camera bag today is certainly going to be very different to what was in my camera bag 2 years ago. And in a moment, we're going to talk about what is in the bag. But first of all, I want to talk about something that hasn't changed, which is the actual bag itself. This is the same bag that I featured in that video 2 years ago. I've had this bag now for 10 years and it's an awesome bag. And I want to tell you a little bit about it. This is the Thinktank Airport Essentials. It's a really good bag for lots of reasons. Number one, it's a backpack and it's really comfortable to wear. Now, when I'm doing my courses and workshops, sometimes these run for a whole day. And obviously we're walking around all day in Brisbane. It can be pretty hot at times, but this bag is very comfy and cool and easy to carry around. It's got really wide straps. It's got lots of nice padding. So one of the main reasons I like this bag is it's comfy. Number two is it's roomy. There is a ton of room and you're going to see for yourselves inside this bag, so I can get lots of gear inside, which is great. And of course, like any good camera bag, you can reconfigure the insides to suit whatever kit you have. The other thing I like about this bag, and there's a clue in the name, Airport Essentials, is that you can carry this onto a plane. It complies with most airlines airport carry-on specifications or requirements, if you like. I've traveled with this bag around Australia. I've flown with this bag to Europe and America, and I've had no issues at all with this bag. So look, if you're a traveling photographer and you like to get on planes occasionally, this could be the bag for you. So you might want to check it out. Now, as well as having plenty of space inside for things like cameras, lenses, and so on, I can also carry my laptop around if I want to, or an iPad. There's plenty of room in the front panel. I'll show you this. Generally, day to day, I've got an iPad in the front here. It's in there now, but I can easily get a laptop in here if I wish. And there's lots of pockets here, which I actually don't need to use, but there's plenty of storage space, space in the front of the bag. Now, the other thing is there's a space in the side for a tripod. I've got a mini tripod inserted into the side of the bag. We'll come back to that in a moment. I love the fact they've put a handle, not just on the top of the bag, but the side of the bag. It might not seem like a big deal, but trust me, if you're flying and you're lifting this into the overhead compartment above the seats, having a side handle is really, really useful. This bag is water repellent. So if you get caught in a light shower, you're going to be fine. It is not water resistant, but that doesn't matter because when you buy this bag, they give you a rain jacket for it as well. I'll show you that soon. And one final little touch, which is really cool, is that you can, if you want, padlock all of the zips. And added security tucked into the side of the bag is this. This is a little pull-out lock. It's securely attached to the bag. It's got a little combination lock here. So what you can do if you want to is you can attach this to maybe, I don't know, a fence or a heavy chair or something like that. So the bag can't be just grabbed and somebody can run off with it. I've used it a couple of times in airports when I've been close to the bag, but I haven't been able to watch over it all the time. And that again is just a really nice touch. So one of the things I like about this bag is the design. It's got lots of features. They've really thought about the design of the bag. So there you go. That's the bag itself. Let's go back to the tripod. In the side of this bag here, I've got a tripod. If you're a familiar viewer or regular viewer to this channel, you've probably seen this before. This is the Manfrotto Mini Pixie Evo tripod. It's really useful and I use this all the time. It's got a smartphone adapter in the top here, or holder. So if you want, you can put a smartphone in here and you can use this to do photos, videos. I tend to use this a lot when I'm doing time lapses. Now, of course, if you don't want to use a smartphone, if you want to attach it to a camera, no problem at all. You simply remove the phone adapter. Get rid of that. And this will screw into the bottom of a camera. And this will hold most entry-level cameras, but I've also used it on some heavier cameras as well, no problem at all. Because what you can do is extend the legs out like so, and this makes it really, really stable. You can even drop the legs further down, which again, for stability, makes it really, really useful and really stable. You can also use it if you want to as a selfie stick. I'm not a selfie person myself, but you can use it like this if you wish to. So that is a mini tripod that never leaves my bag. I use this all the time. So let's pop that just there. Okay, so now let's get into the contents of the bag. So as I mentioned, there's some pretty heavyweight zips here, and these zips can be locked with a padlock if you want to. Open up the bag, and the first thing we see in the lid is two large pockets which have a mesh, so you can actually see through and see what's inside the pockets. Now there's a handful of things I keep in here. Some of them never leave my bag because they're really useful. Remote for a Canon camera, a remote for a Nikon camera. When I'm doing my photography courses and workshops, Canon, Nikon, they're the cameras I see the most. So I carry remotes so that people, if they want to, can try them out for themselves. I've got a handy tool here as well, which includes a little mini knife. There's a screwdriver and things. So if I need to maybe tighten a tripod up or whatever as well. So that sits inside my bag. That's the front pocket done. In the bottom pocket, I've got a spare battery actually for a Canon camera, because I'm using the Canon 80D quite a bit. I'm using it right now to record this video. I've also got a Nikon battery there. I've got a bunch of spare SD cards, simply because sometimes people turn up to my courses and they forget the SD card. It's not very often, but when it does, obviously I don't want them to miss out on a day. So I carry some spare cards in the bag. And lastly, there's an iPhone charger in here as well. So let's now get into the main compartment. And the first thing I want to pull out is my main camera at the moment, which is this. This is the Nikon Z6. This is a full frame mirrorless camera. I've had this camera now just for a few weeks. And look, I'm so busy doing my courses, workshops, putting these videos together for YouTube that I haven't used it as much as I would like, but hopefully that will change over the coming months. But what I've seen with this camera so far has blown me away. It's a great camera. It's also my first full frame camera. I came very close to buying the Nikon D850 a few months ago, but because Nikon had introduced this camera and because I had an opportunity to check it out beforehand, I was sold. It's an absolutely fantastic camera. And on this camera, I've got the 24-70mm lens. To complement this camera, of course, I've got some lenses. I've got my 70-200mm f2.8 telephoto lens here. I use this quite a bit when I'm doing sports photos. That's usually my son playing soccer or football. My daughter may be doing gymnastics. Great lens, in fact, a fantastic lens. I've had it a number of years. Purchased it quite a few years ago back in the UK, and it complements this camera or any Nikon camera very well indeed. Another lens I've got here is my 17-55mm f2.8 lens. Again, beautiful lens, sharp as anything, nice wide aperture, fantastic. This is a DX lens, so this lens is designed for the smaller sensor Nikon cameras, but up until getting the Z6, all my cameras have been cropped APS-C sensor cameras anyway. I've never had an issue with that. I love them. But I can use this lens on the Nikon Z6 because I also have an adapter. This adapter allows me to use any of the Nikon FX-DX lenses on the mirrorless system. So of course this is going to stay in my camera bag as well. Now this is the hood for the 17-55mm lens. It's a beast of a hood, it's huge. It actually takes up a fair bit of space in my bag, but I'm a big fan of lens hoods. So look, if you haven't got a lens hood, get one. If you have, please make sure you use them. They're not just for sunny days. What else? I've got another camera in my bag as well. This might surprise you. This is the Nikon D3500, which is a really different camera to the Z6 because this is Nikon's entry-level camera. Now, if you're a regular viewer, you'll know that I love this camera. When it came out, I gave it a great review. I'm going to do an update on that very soon. Fantastic entry-level camera, takes amazing photos. And because I do a lot of photography courses and workshops in Brisbane where people aren't bringing cameras like this, they're turning up with cameras like this, I like to use these cameras as much as I can. So this gets a lot of use. And I can use the 70-200 on this. I can use the 17-55 on this. But I've also got a little lens in here that I love to use with the little small lightweight cameras. This is the Nikon 35mm f1.8 prime lens. So this lens, unlike a zoom, is a prime, it's fixed. You can't zoom in and out, but it has a really wide aperture, f1.8, which means it's great in low light, great for getting a nice shallow depth of field. So that's a fantastic lens. Also, over here I've got a couple of filters. Now I'm testing these out at the moment. Polar Pro, which is an American company, were kind enough to send me these to test out. This is a polarizing filter, this is a neutral density filter, and these so far they're great. I'm going to do a full video review of these filters very soon, so make sure you subscribe so you don't miss out. Thoughts on them so far, great, but I'll leave it for the review. Look, if you like landscapes, if you like taking photos of nature and you like taking photos outdoors, I would certainly consider buying a polarizing filter because of what it can do. It can boost and enhance certain colors, blue skies, green grass. It can help reduce reflections and flare. It's a really good filter. So those are sitting in my bag at the moment. I got a power bank over here. This is useful, of course, because when I'm on the go, I don't want my phone to go flat, I don't want my iPad to go flat. So this sits in my bag, fully charged, and that gets a lot of use as well. Little Think Tank SD card holder. So this is for my memory cards, for my SD cards. Never leaves my bag, very useful. Got a heap in there. What can I say about this? It just holds the cards. Interested in what cards I use? Generally, I like to use SanDisk. I don't buy them online. I buy them from stores to make sure that they are the real deal as well, okay? I've heard some horror stories of people buying cheap SD cards on eBay only to find they don't work very well. Also in my bag, I've got some step up and step down rings. These are for filters. So if I have a filter like this one, which is 77 millimeters, it will fit these two larger lenses, but it's too big to go on some of the smaller lenses. So these adapters will adapt the filter thread size to fit a variety of lenses. So that's, you know, something else that's sitting in my bag at the moment while I'm testing out these filters from Polar Pro. And the last thing in my bag here, other than a couple of lens cloths, big shout out to Brisbane Camera Hire for this lens cloth, is this. This is the Raymac that comes with the Think Tank bag. Packed away inside the bag, has got me out of trouble on numerous occasions when we've been caught in showers. And again, very useful. So that is currently the kit that I'm carrying about in my bag. So if you want any more information on any of the contents of my bag, you'll find links in the description below the video. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did, give us a thumbs up. Consider subscribing to my channel. And don't forget, you can leave your questions, comments, and suggestions down below. I hope to see you again sometime soon. See ya. Bye.